Good evening, ma'am. Welcome to the GNLU debate 2014. We are honored to have you here formally and for the felicitation ceremony, and more than that, to give us some out of your time, out of your busy schedule, to have a word with us today. Ma'am, I'd first like to ask you that you personally have been through up and down of the litigation framework of the Indian judiciary, and you've gone through a lot of tremendous pressures and struggles and achievements coming out of flying colors every time. Being the idol of one of the greatest culture that's coming up as a profession, that is law in India, your tryst with law, from being a law student to becoming the additional Solicitor General of India.
I think, you know, you've answered it all. It's a matter of just going up and down. It's like it's been like a roller coaster at times. At times it's been like a slow train. The pitch keeps varying, the pace keeps varying, but what keeps you going in this great field is, I mean, I come from a time when law was not the most popular of professions, in the sense it was not the most sought after. Today I think we are in a totally different frame where everybody takes law as the first choice rather than the last choice, which is to happen. But neither is it, I think it's been a wonderfully enriching experience. I think there's so many things that happen to you, but the main thing is your adrenaline keeps going. Your hormones are so activated because of the pressures that you have within you, because there's no way to meet them. You can't plan out your entire situation. You try your best, you prepare, you study, you plan strategies, you discuss, you debate, you conference. But at the end of the day, it's when you're there and you're actually delivering. It's as good as being with you here today to deliver in front of the media. That's why I always say there's a good comparison between media and law. The difference is this. When you're before the media, you don't necessarily have to be very erudite. In law, you need that knowledge also. You need to know the section. Also, you don't need to know your constitution also. But I think the greatest challenge is actually when innovative arguments come, when innovative situations come, which haven't been handled before. If you have an answer in a precedent, we come in a common law system, then it's easy in a sense to say, you know, we are following this field of law. But when you come up into a different field, I'll just give you a very small example. I was asked to do an arbitration matter, and I was senior counsel for the state of Jharkhand. And my husband and I were going for a film. So I just looked at the brief and we just carried on, and I told one of my juniors to prepare. I said, I'll see it when I come back on the morning. When I reached the cinema hall, I just told my husband, do you mind if we sell the tickets and just go back? I don't think I can manage this case in less than 5-6 hours. I'm not sure how long it will take. It is a complicated proposition. It's actually going against the established law that is there. And the next day when I argued, we came back from the film. The next day when I argued, the judge first said, Ms. Anand, is this what you're arguing? I said, yes, ma'am. And then it was lunchtime. So I said, no, when we continue after lunch, I'll make my proposition good. And when they sat after lunch, initially their response was very critical in the sense they didn't think that was possible. But they heard me and they agreed with me and we won the case. It, of course, was a several crores who were involved in that case. But aside from the monetary value, the sheer fact that it was a very novel argument and you did succeed in that, these are the exciting times. It is part, when you're part of an evolutionary system or an evolution process, that you actually get excited. And I think law keeps you going because you're always delivering, you're always under a challenge. Every day is like an examination, every case is like a test, everything is like a war. So you know, you put all these features together, and at the end of the day, it's like a project which comes through, it's like a debating competition which comes through at the end of 3 days, you know, and then you feel relieved, I've done it.
My second question to you would be, ma'am, that in your opinion, there are like diverse national law universities there in India now, and the like multitude of other national other law universities opening up in private enterprises. In your perspective, how do you think that extracurricular activities like debating and voting can actually contribute to the personality and sense of mind of a budding lawyer?
I'll just make a small modification to your statement. I don't think it is only relevant for a budding lawyer. I think it's important for a budding person. Sure. A person to be a wholesome person needs to have exposure to public activity, needs to have public oratory. In fact, we were lagging in this field. So I'm very happy that one way or the other, whether it's law schools, whether it's other institutions, they've actually picked up, because this is an art of communication. If you can communicate well, whether it is as a lawyer, as a doctor, or any other profession, or as a businessman, that takes you forward. And I think, you know, I always say, I don't think of anybody only as a lawyer. First, a person is a human being. First, a person is a part of this national India, that is this entire economy that forms part of this entire world, then you become a part of a profession. In fact, that's the way we should look at it. But having said that, for a budding lawyer, it's even more important. you actually have to be able to address your fears. So when you speak publicly, when you have debating, it gives you a channel of A, expressing yourself well, B, it gives you a challenge to meet the opposing arguments. That's what I felt. I was used to debate very actively in Delhi University, and fortunately I won a few prizes too. But it was, it's something that developed you along the way, and that's why today, whether it is in the course, whether it's outside, whether it's in public speaking, we were lacking in this field. I think we've done it a very good job. What is most interesting is with the Gujarat National University, that it is not a moot court. I initially thought, as we are judging so many moot courts, we always believe that it's a moot court. So I was actually pleasantly surprised to find it's a debating competition. So it brings it down to the real world. The real world is not only law. The real world is the real world, and law is one part of it. So when you address across board, that's why the subjects also were not only legal issues. They were political, legal, economic, socio subjects that I heard, and you apparently have a grand plan of having a new subject for every team or every new level that you came across, which is so good, because that means that they couldn't actually have prepared too much. It's extemporary. I think our Prime Minister has shown how great extempore speech can be. It is. It communicates more effectively. A written speech can never be as effective as addressing a person across without looking at a paper and being able to express what you think, because then there is connection. There's connection between two people or one person and the public.
Ma'am, my last question to you would be that in a nation as India, which is now booming with practically n number of law universities, where do you place Gujarat National Law University as an institution producing one of the best legal minds that the industry demands today?
I think it's one of the greatest universities in the faculties. I've seen the progress which has been made, the kind of academic input that is going in, the kind of support, the kind of vision, even more strongly. I think the biggest thing is the vision and the will to implement it. If you have the will to implement a vision, I think you can take the whole world with a storm, and this storm is going to take over not only this country, but I hope the entire world.
Thank you so much, ma'am. We are honored to have you here this evening. I hope that we keep getting honored with your presence again and again.
I'd love to be here and to participate and to interact and to be able to get your contributions to do my job too.
Thank you so much.